46 Good Day Charlotte is continuing our coverage of the pipeline cyber attack.
And the last few days, we have learned a lot about just how much we rely on our infrastructure and how fragile it is to hacking. We want to bring in South Carolina U.S. Congressman Ralph Norman. Representative, thank you so much, sir, for being with us this morning.
What's most concerning to you about this cyber attack as we start to learn more, and especially as a member of the Homeland Security Committee?
Well, what concerns me is the fact that this has not been a priority for this administration, and the fact that you've got one company that supplies 43% of the East Coast and being put shut down is very much concerning. And the fact that it could happen to hospitals as it has been, high schools, the airline industry, it affects every part of our economy. And we're just coming out of the COVID relief, and to have this along with the price increases is a serious threat that we've got to take now and not be shallow about it, because it is a national security issue.
Well, you know, you talk about this threat, Congressman, and I think we typically picture terrorism, you know, as a bomb going off or someone shooting someone else, or certainly 9/11 attacks. Because we can't see cyber terrorism, it's you feel like you can't protect yourself. We had the SolarWinds issue last year. So if this is the new terrorism, if you will, how do we protect everything going forward?
Well, what you do is open up the Keystone Pipeline. You know, first thing this president did was shut down a vital part of the production in this country. We're now dependent on foreign countries that don't like us. And the fact that we've shut down the Keystone Pipeline, put hundreds of thousands of people out of work, is serious. We ought to open that back up and become an exporter like we were the previous 4 years. But, you know, this gas is central to our existence here. And the fact that we've been shut down with the COVID virus and now shut down for so many of the businesses because of the gas shortage, and now this cyber attack is not acceptable, and the public ought to be outraged, and they should be.
And Congressman, we know it's one thing to hold a hearing, as you all typically do when issues arise, but what actions do you think can be taken moving forward?
Well, we ought to ask the hard questions. You know, what are you going to do about it? What's the next steps? Is opening the Keystone Pipeline an option now? And what are we going to do to have guardrails? You know, Colonial is a private company, but that's where government has guardrails and sets minimum standards that they have to meet. And I think that's some of the questions we'll be asking. We can't let this go on. And paying the ransom, as school districts out in California have done, United Healthcare, it costs them $67 million. We've got to get serious about this and ask the key officials in the Biden administrations what you're going to do and make suggestions for them.
Congressman, I want to switch gears before we end our time today. We know today's a busy day, a vote to remove Representative Liz Cheney, Congresswoman Liz Cheney this morning, a fellow Republican from her leadership position. What are your thoughts on that, and what's your position? How are you planning to vote today?
Well, I'm going to vote to remove Liz Cheney. I like Liz Cheney, but she was head of the whole conference. And for her to take the position that 75 million people voted for Donald Trump, they're not going anywhere. And for her to take the position to bash him at every opportunity is not right. And so hopefully we'll get her out of leadership and then decide who's next.
Congressman Ralph Norman, I know flying back to Washington, and you are there today. A busy day ahead. Please keep us informed, and thank you so much for your time this morning on Good Day Charlotte. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.